welcome you once again in this new session of history. Today we are going to read about the chapter number 6, the age of Guptas. In this chapter we will read about the accounts of Fahim, a great ruler, about the Samudragupta, Chandragupta, Vikramaditya, the great university, it was known as a Nalanda University, Aryabhatta, a great scientist, and a Kalidas. That means it was the age of an imperial period for the Guptas, when we made the progress in the field of education, science, culture, and that is why it is known as a classical age or a golden age of Indian history. Fahim, accounts of Fahim. Fahim was a Chinese pilgrimage. He visited in India for the religious missions. He traveled to Kapilavastu, Kannauj, Kushinagar, Vaishali, Pataliputra, Kashi, Rajgriha. He said that Magad was very prosperous country with large towns, with wealthy population. He also said that Pataliputra was a flourishing city where numerous charitable institutions, hospitals were built. He also said that the peoples were very wealthy, but they live very simple life. They generally observe the rules conducted by the Buddhist. The four religions were Vaishnavism, Shaivism, Buddhism, Jainism. Hindu god and goddesses were depicted on the coins and also the sculptures and the painters. So we have known about this, that in the Gupta period, the prosperous governed on enlightenment principles. Then second source was the Allahabad pillars. It is very famous source of Gupta dynasty. It is one of the important epigraphic evidence of imperial Guptas. It is composed by the Harisena, the court poet of Samudragupta. Allahabad pillar inscriptions, also known as the Prayag Parasthasti, is written in praise of Samudragupta, arguably the most powerful of the Gupta rulers. So it means Samudragupta was the most powerful ruler. His court poet Harisena composed in the Allahabad pillar, he inscribed the Pragya Prasasti. The reign of Gupta period. In the history of the first two rulers of the Gupta dynasty was Shri Gupta and his sons Ghatotkach. So it is believed that the Gupta era originated with the reign of Chandragupta I. Now Chandragupta I. Who was Chandragupta I? Chandragupta I was the first independent king of King with the title of Maharajadhiraj. Chandragupta I gave his name Maharajadhiraj. That means kings of the king. King of the kings. After declaring his independence as Magad, Chandragupta I extended his empire through the matrimonial alliance to marrying the Lichhavi princess Kumara Devi. Because Lichhavis was very powerful, so Samudragupta married the daughter of Lichhavis. Her name was Kumara Devi. Then Samudragupta. Samudragupta was the son of Chandragupta I. Much of the information about him is obtained from the Allahabad pillar inscription composed by his court poet Harisena. He was a great conqueror. He was also a very able statesman. He was lover of the arts. He patrons of the arts. He extended his empire from Brahmaputra in the east to the river Yamuna and Chambal in the west, and from Himalaya in the north to Narmada in the south. He is known as the Napoleon of India. Napoleon of India. The Allahabad inscriptions of Samudragupta describe four different kinds of Samudragupta's policies. First, nine rulers of Aryavart were uprooted and their kingdoms were made a part of Samudragupta's empire. So there was the nine rulers of Aryavarta whom Samudragupta uprooted. Then the 12 rulers of Dakshinapat, that is from the South India, also surrendered to Samudragupta I, Samudragupta. And then the inner sailor, inner circle of neighboring states, including Assam, coastal Bengal, Nepal, and number of Gana Sanghas in the northwest paid tribute, followed his orders, and attended his court. The ruler also outlying areas to submit him. So according to Samudragupta's court, her court poet Harisena, Samudragupta performed the Ashwamedha Yagya or a horse sacrifice. It is believed that Samudragupta was not only a brave warrior and a conqueror, but also a very great ruler too. He was very fond of music, so he was a very great musician, as well as he was a very good poet also. He also played Veena. Then Chandragupta II or Vikramaditya. He was very much famous for his justice. In the Gupta inscription mentioned in Chandragupta II, succeeded his father Samudragupta. He inherited the military genius of his fathers, and he extended the Gupta empire by conquest his own. He annexed the territories of Sakas, Malwa, Gujarat and Saurashtra. For this he was given the title of Sakadi or a conqueror of Sakas. According to the noted historian Dr. Vincent Smith, said that the annexation of Saurashtra and Malwa not only added the empire province of exceptional wealth and fertility, but it also opened up the port of the western port, and thus Chandragupta II went to Europe and Egypt for business. Gupta administration. The Gupta period saw a gradual disappearance of the republican form of the government, that is monarchy. Monarchy was the prevailing form of government during the Gupta period, where the theory of the divinity of king became popular during this period. The Gupta king were compared to different gods like Yam, Varun, Indra and Kuber. Lakshmi was the goddess of prosperity, and Vishnu was regarded as a function of preserving and protecting the people. Gupta people also enjoyed a large number of powers, which covered the political, administered, military and judicial field. See, these are the Gupta coins where God and goddesses have been inscribed. The king also pompous the title of Parameshwar, Maharaja Adhiraj. And Parambhatraka. Despite the divine element attribute to the Gupta king, the Brahman were the chief custodians. They interpreted the law, they exercised and checked their royal power. then the Council of Ministers. The Gupta rulers had their councils, like Kalidas, the renowned poet, referred to the Mantri Parishad. It consisted of the prince, the high officials. Then the high officers were Kumara Matya. Kumara Matya formed the chief cadre for recruiting high functionaries. The office of the Sandvigrahika, that is the Ministry of Peace and War, was appeared during the Samudragupta, and Harisena held this title. Now the provincial and the local administration, according to the Gupta ruler, evolved the first systematic provincial and the local administration. And their provincial administration was? It was the core of empire. They were directly controlled by the Guptas, then divided into Bhuktis, and each of these placed under the charge of Uprikha. And the Uprikha was the governor appointed by the king. The Bhuktis were divided into Vishyas and Vishyapati. Vishay was divided into smaller units, and the fiscal administrative units such as Desa, Mandala, Bhoga, etc. Then came the village administrator, and the village administration was managed by the village headman, who was the senior of the village. He took the village administration. The Gupta inscription referred to the participation of leading local element in the administration of the village of small town called Vithis. And in the town administration, it was Janpadas, which were used as seals and coins, and they were administered by the committee of five, and these being administered by some kind of parishad. And in the Janpadas, there were the five committees, and those five committees look after the law and order of the town administration. In the town, the Gupta Empire were usually placed under the officers. They were called Purapala. And the feudal nature of polity, that is the Mauryan state, the system of the administration underwent several changes under the Guptas. In the period of the Mauryan state, it is created with the comprehensive competence based on the centralized control. Guptas also had control the same thing. They have been true, it is rule in the core area of the middle age of Ganga plain. Gupta period shows the process of devolutions of the state authority. And the first of the priestly class, and later it was the warrior class. The class was divided into two parts, a priestly class and the warrior class. So that's all for today's session. We will meet in our next session with the new topic of the same chapter. Till then, have a nice day and take care of your health.